So, girls, in the previous paragraphs that I have just read, you see, they described the house that Thyapa went to have a recce of the house. They said that the house was beautiful. It was located in a very picturesque, scenic beauty. Beautiful. It had scenic beauty around it, and there were shops down the lane, and there was everything that a house had to have. It had sofas, it had tables, and even a mirrored rack to hang hats and umbrellas, and it had water and electricity. So there was everything in the house, and he felt it was perfect for a family to move into the house. And he was about to leave that very evening, they said. The very next morning, he wanted to leave. And let's see what happened then. Suddenly, it started raining cats and dogs, as is common in any hilly area. The sky, the mountains and the valley were suddenly engulfed by a thick fog. One could not tell whether it was still day or night had swiftly fallen over the hills. It was at this time that someone started pounding on the door. So you see in the picture, the house which was described in the earlier paragraph, and he says as he was about to leave, it suddenly started raining. And then it was a time in hill stations, you don't know when it's going to be night, when dusk is setting in. So they say that one could not tell whether it was day or night. And maybe this was late in the evening, and he heard a pounding on the door. Somebody was knocking at the door. Let's see what happens on the next page. Thyapa opened it and saw a rickety old Englishman with a small briefcase in hand and drenched to his skin, staring back at him. There were patches of moss and mud on his trousers. So Thyapa assumed that the man may have slipped and fallen somewhere. His cheeks were hollow, his face pale. He was shivering in the cold, his teeth chattering incessantly. "May I please come in?" he asked. "Of course. What a day," Thyapa blurted. "Why don't you change into some warm clothes and have some tea, please?" He tried to play the perfect host. The two beds in the bedroom had a blanket each. After tea, the Englishman opened his briefcase to reveal wads of 100-rupee notes, which he carefully laid out on the mat to dry. Then he slipped into bed, but he kept shivering even with two blankets. So Thyapa tucked his most favorite hot water bottle under the man's feet. Then he had dinner and fell fast asleep. The rain continued for 3 days at a stretch. It was no great surprise that they soon ran out of food. Thyapa searched the kitchen and located a small premise stove and a torn umbrella. He ran to the corner shop to get rice, lentils, potatoes, onions and a bottle of oil. However, trying to light the stove was another matter. He would have surely burnt the house down had not the Englishman come running and adjusted the flame. Thyapa's visitor was very affable. He had high fever yet refused to have anything but tea and condensed milk. Although Thyapa was a wee bit curious, the old man consciously avoided talking about his banknotes. Instead, he simply stacked them back into his briefcase once they had dried. Beams of bright sunshine flooded the room on the third day. The sky was clear and blue. Thyapa packed his bags, bid farewell to the Englishman, and left for the station. On his return to Calcutta, he was told that the family had decided to go to Ghatshila instead because he had taken too long to return. His eldest aunt had already left for the place the previous day. The turn of events quite upset Thyapa. What we have read in the above paragraphs was that Thyapa wanted to leave, but he stayed back because it was raining. And then an Englishman comes pounding on the door and he opens it. He invites the Englishman in, feeling sorry for him that he was drenched, he was wet, and then he offered him some tea. He tried to play the perfect host. That means he tried to be very hospitable to him and he wanted him to be comfortable. So he covered him with two blankets because he found that he was shivering. And after that, they even started to cook there. And he had a small stove which he started to cook on, and He said once the Englishman even came running to help him because he nearly burnt down the house. The Englishman had to come and adjust the flame. And then after spending 2 days there with the rain, on the third day, they both of them bade farewell to each other. And then Thiappa left that day to Calcutta to go and tell his aunt that it was a very nice house where they could go and settle down. But then when he returned to Calcutta, the aunt, finding him taking too long to return, she decided to go to another place, Ghatshila. And so this upset Thiappa because he wanted them to stay in this place, Kursong. It's because he found it to be very comfortable and very beautiful. The surroundings were beautiful, picturesque, as they said. And so Thiappa thought that they would move in there, but then he came too late, and by the time his aunt had already left for another place. So now let's go on to what happened after this. 15 years passed by. Thiappa was a family man now. Once deciding to visit Kursong during the puja vacations, he looked up the same house again. It was available. This time, he voluntarily undertook the responsibility of inspecting it. Hence, on reaching the place, he deposited his suitcase with the station master and quickly walked up to the house. He planned to return that very evening. Every bit of this visit mirrored the previous one. The charming house, the crooked creaky gate, the absence of the watchman, the open glass door, the light in the bedrooms, and the water from the taps. As if that were not enough, clouds enveloped the sky, the mountains and the valley in blinding darkness, and it began to rain heavily. Suddenly, Thiappa heard knocks on the door, just as on that night 15 years ago. He opened the door. Before him, there stood an old rickety Englishman with a small briefcase, the same man who had visited Thiappa years ago. His eyes were hollow, his face pale, and his teeth chattered from the cold. Thiappa saw the patches of moss and mud on his trousers. "May I come in, please?" he asked. Or rather, "May I please come in?" he asked. Thiappa held the door wide open, slid past the Englishman, and tore down the carved path towards the railway station. The rain lashed on without stopping. Not once did Thiappa stop to look back. So girls, what you see, or what you have heard just now, that after 15 years, this man Thiappa comes back. He wanted to visit the same place, and somehow he comes back to the same house, and he goes directly and takes the keys and goes into this house. And as he begins to settle down, the same thing happened which happened 15 years ago. It started raining, and then the same pounding he heard on the door, and when he opened it, it was the same Englishman again, drenched, and came with the same briefcase that he held. And so Thiappa knew that this was not something to be coincidence. This was not happening usually that should have happened. It seemed to be all something very weird, and Thiappa just took him to be a ghost. And that's why they say that Thiappa ran out of the house. When he seen the Englishman and when he said, "May I come in?" What did Thiappa do? He held the door open wide and he slid past the Englishman and tore down the curved path. He ran down the curved path towards straight to the station. And he never looked again. So that's why we say Thiappa had a narrow escape. And now girls, you can see some meanings there in the boxes. Rickety, not strong, frail. The Englishman was a rickety person. Incessantly means non-stop. Where do you come across this? It was raining incessantly, non-stop rain. And you can see that premise is a small movable oil stove. Affable, a friendly person. The Englishman was a friendly person. Wee bit is a little bit mirrored. They said everything mirrored the same thing that happened as he came on his previous visit. So mirrored here means everything was similar. You know, when you look into the mirror, you find your same face. So everything was similar. And now you got about the writer, Leela Majumdar. So what I've told you about the writer that she used to translate, she translated Jonathan Swift, Gulliver's Travels. Jonathan Swift's Gulliver's Travels and Ernest Hemingway's The Old Man and the Sea into Bengali. I earlier told you that she translated English into Bengali and Bengali into English. So girls, I think you have understood the lesson and you can read it once again on your own to see if you have missed out on anything, if you couldn't understand. And you can see that this was a very mysterious happening, and you know now that why it was so mysterious, that I told you it's a mysterious lesson. Now you've got reading comprehension, girls. Right, true or false for these statements. So you can do that after reading the lesson. And if you have any doubts about that, when we meet again or when I go on to the next lesson, I will clear those doubts for you. And you have read these sentences from the story and answer the questions that follow. Why don't you change into some warm clothes and have some tea, please? Who said these words and to whom? You know that very well, girls. Try to answer all that on your own. Why did the speaker ask the person to change into warm clothes? I guess it's not difficult for you to answer. Where had the other person come from? What did Thyapa do to make the person comfortable? So there are two references to context here. Please try to answer them in your rough notes, girls. I will be sending the notes and some exercises for you to do, or maybe some grammar work too will be sent later on. So for now, please read the lesson again and try to do these exercises and also the reference to context. Okay, girls, have a good day.